We want to solve the given absolute value inequality by expressing the solution as a compound inequality, a graph, and using interval notation. We have the absolute value of the quantity x minus 3 divided by 2 is less than or equal to positive 1. And since absolute value represents a number's distance from 0, we're looking for the values of x where x minus 3 divided by 2 would have a distance from 0 that's less than 1 unit. And since the original inequality is less than or equal to, that means we'll have a compound inequality or two inequalities connected by the word and. So for the first inequality, we'll just drop the absolute value. So we'll have the quantity x minus 3 divided by 2 is less than or equal to 1. And for the second inequality, we'll drop the absolute value. But then we're also going to reverse the inequality and change the sign of the 1. So we'll have greater than or equal to negative 1. And now we're going to solve each of these inequalities, graph their solutions, and then because we have an and, we'll look for the intersection of the two intervals for the solution of the original absolute value inequality. So to isolate x, we'll first undo this division. Remember, a fraction bar means division, so we're going to multiply both sides by positive 2. You could think of this as positive 2 over 1. So these 2's simplify out, and we're left with x minus 3 is less than or equal to positive 2. And then we'll add 3 to both sides. So here we have x is less than or equal to 5. And now we'll solve the second inequality. Again, the first step is the same. We're going to multiply both sides by 2. So this simplifies out, and we're left with x minus 3 is greater than or equal to negative 2. Add 3 to both sides. And here we have x is greater than or equal to positive 1. And now we'll go ahead and graph both of these inequalities on the number line and look for the intersection. For the first inequality, x is less than or equal to 5. Notice how 5 does satisfy this inequality and therefore is in the interval. So we make a close point on positive 5, and then an arrow to the left for values less than 5. And then for x is greater than or equal to positive 1, again, positive 1 is in this interval, so make a close point on positive 1, and an arrow to the right. Now this is not the graph of our solution. We need to analyze this. Because it's an and, we're looking for the intersection of these two intervals, or the intervals in which the values are graphed twice, and we can see it's going to be the closed interval from positive 1 to positive 5. Let's go ahead and regraph this so it only shows the closed interval from 1 to 5. So it would look like this. And then to express this using interval notation, we have the interval from 1 to 5. This is a closed interval, meaning it includes the endpoints, so we use square brackets. We'll take a look at one more example in the next video.